Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm Lei Zhang from Chukong Technologies, a leading mobile game developer and publisher in China. Are we all having fun here at PG Connects? Yes or no?
Yay.
Yeah, if it's a no, I'm going to ask Chris for a refund of our sponsorship. See, we've been sponsoring and supporting Pocket Gamer for a long time, starting from, I think, the early days of App Store, of the app economy picking up. The reason why we're doing that is not because, not only because Pocket Gamer is a very influential force in the mobile gaming space, but also it's a community. It's the developers around Pocket Gamer property. And I think that clicks with our root, which is called Coco China. It's the iOS and later on Android developer community in China. So I think that brought the two companies together. Though later on we took a different route, we became one of the largest mobile game publishers in China, but still we share the same vision, which is to build, create, and maintain a very vibrant and healthy ecosystem around developers. So that's the root of us. And in the past 2 years, I've been trying to advocate that China market is a viable market for international developers to not only get download numbers, but also revenue. I think previously, Junde from Appany shared those revenue numbers. So there are really real dollars to be made from that market. So today, I'm not going to just give big numbers again, which has been done before a couple times. Instead, I'm going to share you a very detailed case study that we've been working on with a top brand and top game franchise in the world, which is Where's My Water. Our team, in particular, Chukong's ATH Studio, worked with the Where's My Water studio of Disney Mobile to bring this great title into China market. And how do we make that successful is something that we want to share with you. So with that, I'm going to introduce Yumiao Lu. She's the founder and the executive producer of Chukong's ATH Studio, and she has poured her heart and soul into this game. That's why I want her to give you the personal explanation of this process and experience in Chinese, and I'm going to do the translation. So, Yumiao.
Okay, hello. 大家好,我是ATH的 负责人,也是一个制作人。首先非常谢谢 Chris 的邀请, 能够来到这么美丽的城市伦敦, 和大家分享, 我们做游戏的一些心得。
I'm Yumiao from ATH Studio. Thank you, Chris, for the invitation coming to beautiful city of London to share the idea and concepts of creating games.
OK, 那么接下来呢,我将从几个方面来跟大家分享一下我们在制作 Where's My Water 的系列第四部 Where's My 喜羊羊的这个游戏过程当中的一些有意思的事情。
So actually, Where's My 喜羊羊 is the fourth sequel of Where's My Water franchise. So we're going to share some of the aspects of the interesting points about this process, some secret ingredients of how to make this game successful in China. So part one is designed for culturalization.
OK, 首先呢,我跟大家可以介绍一下喜羊羊的这个形象。那喜羊羊可以称作为是中国市场的Mickey Mouse,因为从05年播出以来,在这八年的时间里边总共有1000多集,然后每年呢都会出1到2部的大电影,可以说它的影响力在中国是非常大的。
Xiang is a major cartoon character originated from China, created by Chinese artists. It has the status of a Mickey Mouse in China. Since 2005, when this cartoon character was created, up to now there are 1,000 episodes of the TV episodes, and also every year there are one or two major feature films from this character, from this franchise.
Okay, 而 Where's My Water 这个游戏呢，也是迪士尼非常成功的手游产品之一。所以说呢，那我们工作室当接到这个 case 的时候呢，我们想的核心的问题就是怎么样把这两个顶尖的产品能够完美的结合在一起。
And Where's My Water is a well-known franchise from Disney Mobile. And the key question or challenge that our studio tried to resolve when we look at this case was to how to combine these two great IPs integral in an integral way instead of just putting some reskin of the original Where's My Water game.
OK, 首先呢，我们知道Where's My Water 的核心呢是一个解谜游戏，那么它的核心是元素之间的这样的一个转化关系。那么在 Where's My 喜羊羊这个游戏当中呢，首先我们就要考虑的是我们如何把这种元素呢以中国式的方式呢呈现给大家。
So as we all know, Where's My Water is a puzzle game, and the key of the game is elements. In addition to diverting water. So the elements, the conversion of the different elements and the relationship between the elements is the core. So the key thinking of the team is to how to give that element aspect of the game a new Chinese interpretation.
OK, 那我们从中国太极文化当中呢选择了这种阴阳的这样的一个关系，我们得出了一个五行的元素。那么五行我可以跟大家解释一下，是金木水火土。
So there is a circle of five elements in Chinese culture, starting from metal, wood, water, fire, and earth, and originated from Tai Chi, and that is deeply in the culture of of China.
Okay, 我们利用这个中国人非常熟悉的元素关系呢，来完成整个这个游戏的一个核心。
So there are a relationship between these elements either complementing each other or offsetting each other, which are very well known to the Chinese population. So we use that as the core of the game design.
Okay, 那么我们在关卡设计的时候呢，其实上也用到了很多跟中国非常传统文化相结合的一些 idea.
So in the level design, we also leverage many of the Chinese cultural aspect.
OK, 比如说春节这个关，我可以跟大家讲一个非常有意思的事情，就是说每年在春节的期间，在中国会这个人口流动会将近十亿，也就可以看出来说节日对于中国人来说是非常的重要，所以说我们第一个灵感的来源于就是节日。
So the first inspiration is about festivals, traditional Chinese festivals. So spring festival is where Chinese people go back to home to meet stay with their family, and there's 1 billion people moving during that period of time. So that shows the importance of that festival. So one particular level design is spring festival.
OK, 那么我们中间的这个春节的关卡呢，我们其实是把春节期间家人需要团聚，然后一起吃饺子这个过程呢，用关卡的形式完美的展现。那么我们可以一会儿呢，让来演示一下这边的一个动画效果。
So I've shown the animation already, which is if you see the shape of that little ball there, actually it's a dumpling.So dumpling making and dumpling eating is a tradition of spring festival. So that is being reflected in the game already.
Okay. 那么接下来我跟大家讲一下这个另外一个关卡，我们称之为春分的这样一个关卡。为什么说中国人的很多节日可以和季节相联系这么紧密？因为中国传统五千年的文化当中呢，中国传统是一个这个农耕的这样的一个王国，所以说呢，每个人对于土地以及季节的这种渴望呢，是根深蒂固的。那么我们在春分这个关卡当中呢，实际上是希望跟大家展示一个春天来了，万物复苏这样的一个情景。
Another level is called Spring Equinox. So many of the Chinese festival also is related to seasons, because Chinese traditionally is an agricultural country. So this particular level shows spring is coming and there are plants growing. And as you can see, these are either obstacles or the key elements of the game. And one thing I want to point out is, I think if you missed the animation, so the level where there's the dumpling, it's not only the shape of the dumpling is showing here, but also the process of making a dumpling is starting from the stuffing and then sealing of the dumpling wraps. So that is actually how you're supposed to solve this puzzle.
好，那我们在关卡设计当中呢，还有一个灵感的来源于是中国的成语。那我可以跟大家在座的各位普及一下中国的这个教育啊，就是在我们这个小学期间，我们都会学习很多跟成语相关的这样的一个知识。所以说，成语呢也是中国文化当中非常重要的一个组成部分。那么在这两个关卡当中呢，我们通过一个过河拆桥的关卡，其实是讲了一个三国时期曹操和张飞的这样的一个故事。
So another element, as an example of the Chinese culture being introduced in the game, is idiom. So there are the four character idioms in China that is rhymed and also has a historical background. So that has been used to introduce the level design of the game. One example is burning the bridge. So there's the same saying in the English world as well, but burning the bridge actually came from the Three Kingdom era, where there's a famous general and a famous king, they had a war. So that was introduced into the game as well.
Okay, next. 好，那么接下来给大家看到的这个关卡呢，是在 Where's My Water 系列里边，完全是一个全新的一个解谜的这样的一个关卡。那我刚才跟大家聊过，就是说，中式关卡谜题呢，是我们希望在 Where's My 喜羊羊这个游戏当中所体现的。那么我们从这个中国的榫卯家具，以及榫卯建筑当中呢，获取了很多的灵感。我们把这种其实可以跟大家简单的介绍一下榫卯家具的这样的一个组成。
Yeah, so another key element is a new mechanism that was introduced into the game, into the puzzle, is called a Chinese tenon. So the tenon are actually used in many woodworks, including furniture, including Chinese buildings, and we've introduced that into something that in the game the player can interact and also can operate.
如果在座的朋友有去过北京的话，在北京天坛的祈年殿是一个非常奇迹的建筑，因为在整个建筑里边是没有用到任何一个钉子的结构，而是完全用木质的榫卯结构呢来完成的。那就像跟大家展示的这个明式的古典家具也是一样的，就是说中间呢是没有任何可以连接的结构，而完全是利用木头和木头之间的衔接来完成的。
So one example in Chinese culture or structure is the heaven, the temple of heaven, and in this case is the Ming Dynasty's furniture. There's no one single nail being used in the furniture's structure, but it's all based on a tenon.
Okay. Okay. 所以说我们整个的这个刚才看到的这个榫卯的结构呢，灵感呢就是来自于跟大家介绍的一个榫卯的建筑。那接下来呢，跟大家介绍一下，就是如何来延展一款游戏的系列游戏的生命周期。
Now we've covered the game design, but now this slide is about the aspect how to extend the life cycle of a game and of a franchise.
OK, 我们可以看到这样的有一个核心的一个图。那我们知道说Where's My Water 到现在已经出了第四部。那么中间呢是小鳄鱼系列。那么每一代都通过玩法模式、故事以及这个社交呢来不断的拓展和完善。
So starting from Where's My Water, there's Where's My Perry, Where's My Mickey, and the fourth generation is Where's My 喜羊羊。So the game actually, if you pay attention, is extending, expanding itself, evolving itself in the four areas. The story it's telling, the social aspect, the key play mechanism, as well as the business model.
Okay. 那么针对中国市场呢，我们主要是在计费模型的这样的一个构架上呢进行了一个完善。我们知道小鳄鱼的这个计费模式呢是付费下载，然后关卡解锁的这种模式。
So for the China market, in addition to the new play mechanisms that has been introduced earlier, we paid a lot of attention to the business model. So for the Where's My Water and Where's My Perry, which also published by Chukong Technologies, we leveraged the unlock mechanism, free download and paid unlock further levels for the Chinese market. And that acted well with the Chinese audience. But for Where's My 喜羊羊, we further extend the in-app purchase mechanism of the game.
OK, 那么我们在这个计费模型上主要是有两个突破。第一个呢是我们做了一个基于人物性格的这样的一个道具体系。那么喜羊羊家族呢，除了喜羊羊和灰太狼是我们非常熟悉的这个知名的形象之外呢，我们还有很多小伙伴们。我们把这种熟知的小伙伴们的形象和道具体系呢结合起来。
And one key creative aspect of the business model for Xiangyang is, for Xiangyang movie, there are hundreds of characters. So we created a power-up system based on these characters.
OK, 那么第二点呢，是我们加入了这样的一个货币体系，因为在中国中度和休闲玩家当中呢，付费下载的这种玩家的数量和意愿是非常少的。
And additionally, we also equally important is we introduced the virtual currency system based on a Xiangyang prop, which is a bell. So in China, there's no paid download and there's no premium game essentially, but people are very, very familiar with freemium model. So we introduced the virtual currency That is also echoing very well with the audience.
Okay. Okay, 那我们可以看到经过我们对游戏的内置付费的这个调整之后呢，我们有两个不一样的这个比例。
So the end result is that in comparing where's my water, the original where's my water's IAP and I purchase breakdown, which is 80% from level unlock and 20% from virtual goods or in I purchase buying. But for where's my XYY or Xiangyang is 50-50. Okay, so that covered the game design aspect of our contribution to the game. Now we're coming to the local distribution. You have a great game, and that's not the end of the story. So to be able to succeed in the mobile gaming market in China, you have iOS and Android, and we've mentioned that Android market is probably bigger than iOS, and for casual games, actually, it's probably four times bigger. So Android probably accounts for 80% of the total revenue on the market. That's very especially true for casual games. For iOS, of course, you need to get the store feature, and that's the end result for this title. And for Android, there are 100-plus Android channels. One of the larger one is 360, and there's 9.1, there's UC, there's Tencent, etc. And also, for Android, it's probably more important to get the store promotion. So what we're showing here is the end result. But how do we get that? It's this. So in China, what is very different is, yes, you have ad network that is probably work effectively on the iOS end, but not as effective on the Android side. But in China, especially for a branded IP, it is possible to do offline advertising or marketing. So in this case, this is the launch activity for where's my XYY. And the next slide, what is shown is a combination of where's my XYY game with a very popular reality show. It's called Dad, Where Are You Going? So for this particular event, the turnout, it's in a shopping mall in China, turnout is 40,000 people. So you don't know the CPI. The CPI could be like 40,000 people, maybe 400 that would download the game. However, it does generate the buzz, does generate that kind of influence in that environment that will influence the featuring. Of course, for any of the publishing partnership, the key is collaboration. No matter how complex the collaboration is, like Where's My YY, which is a core development, or it's just SDK. So this is where our team is working with the core Where's My Xiangyang team, XYY, Where's My Water team. So the Where's My Water designers are playing the levels designed by Yumiao's team. It's a really fun process. And the success of the title, of course, it comes from the team itself, from the execution itself. So as we've shown, we have a strong team that on the design side, as well as on the marketing side. And the end results, unfortunately, I cannot share the actual download number or revenue number with you. However, I can show a trailer of the game, which is, again, Yumiao's team has poured their heart and soul into the game, and we feel very proud of. Okay, so in terms of the game's performance, what I can say is it does carry over its legendary performance worldwide from XYY, Where's My Water into China. And as one of the largest mobile game publishers in China, I do hope we have an opportunity to work with you as well. Thank you.